hi, welcome back to our channel, the Polo Twins.
My name is Kiabetso Polo.
And my name is Kinelo Polo.
So what are we talking about today?
So this week, we're just wrapping up on what we've been talking about for the past couple of weeks, where we've just been giving advice on the subjects that you can choose and career path that you want to choose, and how would you best make sure that you get acceptance into university.
Exactly. So talking from experience, as some of us didn't finish in record time, but we'd like for you guys to finish in record time. So one thing that I realized that what made me to repeat certain subject was that I didn't take my work serious. Like most times I would be playing with friends or going on movies, going where and there. And then when I got into my postgrad, well, I finished my postgrad in record time and I did very well. I realized that I was going to the library. I was doing my work well ahead of time, which is something that we need to do when you're in varsity, so that when you go into class, you know what you don't understand and you are able to ask the things that you don't understand well ahead before you go for your tests and your exams.
Yeah, the other tip that I would give is to remember why you went into varsity in the first place, or you went into a higher institution. It's very important to not lose focus as to why you got there, because there's so many things that will come in the way and make you lose focus. Things like extramural activities, where you spend so much time doing all the extramural activities that are now becoming priority more than your work. Even dating is secondary to why you got into the university that you got to. Remember the first thing that got you there, and always make sure that it's a priority in everything that you do. If you have to sacrifice, you cannot sacrifice that one. Everything else can be sacrificed, but not the reason why you are there.
Okay, my other point is being able to ask in class. You know, as black people or black students, if I may put it that way, sometimes we become, what's the word?
Self-conscious,
and you're thinking, what will people say? Maybe I'm asking a stupid question. Everybody knows it. Nothing is ever stupid. So be able to raise your hand in class and ask the lecturer that I do not understand 1, 2, and 3.
And adding on to that, if you don't have the courage and the confidence to ask in class, you can always make an appointment with the tutors, the demis, the lecturer themselves, and maybe go into their office and just explain that I don't understand this, I don't understand that. Remember also, some things, most of the courses are going online right now. So also set up a meeting with the lecturer, even if it's online, just to say, this I did not get, but you will only realize you didn't get something if you study, right?
Exactly.
Like Yavis has mentioned, that you would need to put in the work as well. You can't depend on class lectures. You don't understand, maybe try YouTube videos, try the books, try going to the library groups, and only then, after you've used up all those resources, then you can go out and ask a tutor and ask a lecturer and say, ma'am, I really don't understand this. I thought this is how I understand it. Also, it's very important to go in and say, this is how I understand it, because they can pick up where you are going wrong.
Yeah,
but if you don't say that, we can't even pick up where you are going wrong.
And yeah, you yourself, sometimes you don't know what you don't understand. I don't know, probably just me, but sometimes you just don't know what you think you understand something, then the test comes and you realize, I don't understand this.
When you apply for an internship, because most of the time when you finish varsity, you apply for internship, unfortunately they look at your academic record, and they do.
It's not a good look if it's,
yeah, if it's very long. You want your first day to be everything passed, preferably with distinction most of the modules. But if you can get a 65% and above, even in order for you to get to honors, guys, to get to BTEC, you need a minimum of 65% average. So if otherwise, you're gonna end up with your undergrad, or you're gonna end up struggling to find that internship. So make sure that you pass so you can go into postgrad, or you can get into an internship or graduate program or whatever, the first step into the corporate world. Passing very well will open those doors for you.
Yes. We're not saying if you didn't pass well, you're not going to get it. It will just be a struggle as compared to somebody who did well. That's just what we're saying. So don't get us wrong.
And you will get bursaries as well. You can get bursaries in your second, third year, even in your honors level.
Even your modules, they get reduced for every distinction that you get.
That you get, yes. Your fees will get reduced. So make sure that you pass really well. If you are using NSFAS can wipe your debt. If you are passing really well, they will reduce the amount of debt that you have if you have distinctions are passing well. So remember, even if you're using NSFAS, you're not using a bursary, to make sure that you pass extremely well in your varsity days.
So if you have more
tips and tricks,
you can comment down below and give us those tips and tricks, or tell us what you would like to see more into our channel. Don't forget to click the subscribe button. Don't forget to comment, like, and share this video.
So until next time, please comment and tell us what you would like us to talk about. But for this week, that's all we had for you. Until next time,
bye.